This is Speak My Word Ministries, Travis Zimmerman. The Daily Pulse today is first in a series of three on an incident that occurred here where I just totally saw God's hand. And I want to share with you the lessons God's teaching me through that. What happened is, I want to keep it anonymous because I don't want to embarrass an organization, but I had applied for a certain waiver. And I had explained about the life circumstances we were going through and, you know, what's going on with my wife Suzanne having fallen downstairs about a year and a half ago, and with my job situation and with my mom and my dad and my son breaking his leg. I mean, I threw the kitchen sink at out of integrity, you know, these things truly did happen, and I was asking for a waiver. And the feedback came back that there was not proper justification. And I totally accept that as God's will, but it just came across so harsh. And it came across in an email, so I'm thinking, you know, I'm gonna, and I know myself, I said, let me wait. But I was gonna wait like 20 minutes and fire off a reply, and I shared the situation with Suzanne, my wife, and she said, Travis, don't write an email. Nothing good can come from it. And I thought, you know what, she's right. She's absolutely right. You know, in the 19 years Suzanne and I have been together, you know, you learn every day about how to submit to one another as you submit to Christ. And you know, we have our own wills, and we want to do what we want to do. And Suzanne has such good advice. She could be a counselor, and I prayed that she is able to achieve her dream of getting that degree in counseling, because she's just a marvelous counselor. It's a gift from God. And she's a gift. So the scripture I want to share with you specifically that talks to about submission to one another is out of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21. It says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. And that's exactly right. Submit to one another. Now, that's not necessarily, you know, specifically in this case, Paul's not talking directly about a husband and wife, but, I mean, and that's coming up, and I argue that it does, but really, that's where I'm using the context of it, submitting to one another as husband and wife. You know, if it's always her way or always his way, there's not balance there, and that's not the basis of a healthy marriage. So I honored my wife in that and said, you know what? No, honey, I won't do that. That's first part. In Jesus' name, amen.